Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the foundation of Yitzchok. Rabbi Yosef Chaim Schwab. Before we begin tonight's event, just a few quick and important announcements regarding upcoming our programs and events. But before we do the announcements, I want to just give a quick shout out to the sponsors and the people that helped make tonight's event possible. First one, my good friend Benjamin, who dedicated tonight's shiur. That's the Chazaq, Benjamin, Ben, Bora, and Maya, Sebti, Baduba. We have a tzachah in all that they do, amen. Also, we want to thank the Nastura family for dedicating tonight's event in loving memory of Netanen Ben Netaniel Ben Istam's Dushar, whose yartzei is tonight. Baruch Hashem, Denecher, Ben, amen. Regarding upcoming Chazaq events and programs, this Sunday, Chazaq will be having two very interesting events. One will be for couples, which will be a Shalom workshop at the Youngers of Pugarn Hills, featuring Rabbi Yaakov Horowitz from Project Yes and many other speakers and presenters. The program starts at 9:30 a.m. till 3:30 p.m. all day, breakfast and lunch included. There will be opening remarks for other shofars from the shul. The MC will be Elul, which is a medium, which will be a very interesting event for couples. All couples are invited to come. And the teens that are in the Chazaq season will be having a community basketball tournament for any teenagers that are interested. Obviously, they'll be part of the program of women and other things as well. So that's this Sunday. There are pamphlets for all these events you'll see on the table there that you can grab. But I'll continue with the announcements. A week from tonight, Chazaq will be having Rabbi Yinon Kalazan from the Arachim, senior lecturer for Arachim. The topic is love, the ideal versus reality. That's the congregation Beth Eliyahu in Fresh Meadows. Men and women are welcome, definitely encouraged to come. Next Sunday night, very, very special event with world-renowned lecturer Rabbi Pesach Prone. Save the date and don't miss out, August 23rd. Location is the Youngers of Jamaica Estates. Should be an unbelievable event in Hashem. That's going to be Sunday night, August 23rd. Please join the freshman 8:30 lecture. Men and women are welcome. That's, once again, the Youngers of Jamaica Estates. Two more announcements. Chazaq will be having a pre-Rosh Hashanah suit sale to benefit Chazaq. We're going to be having Borsellino hats, only 150 suit jackets, wool dress pants, shirts, raincoats, belts, boots, ties. Again, amazing stuff for a very, very, very big sale. So, closing to benefit the organization. Once again, you'll see the flyers that's being posted and emails all around. Last but not least, is that our main annual fundraising event is coming up, September 9th, the third annual Chazaq dinner, which will be taking place on Terrace in the Park. We're going to be honoring the Phineas and Gishman Award, and we're going to Rabbi Yitzchok Olbam, the father of the Rabbi Yitzchok, very active with the organization as well. Youth Leadership Award, Mr. and Mrs. Simple Mishayev from Beit Gabriel. Mr. and Mrs. Simple Mishayev from Beit Gabriel, the President of the Award from the Congregation of Ora Torah. Mr. and Mrs. Manny Behar, which is again with the Community Citizen Award. It's going to be an unbelievable event with Hashem, expecting a very large turnout as usual. If you can't make it for whatever reason, we'll be having a dinner journal. Everyone could participate with that and show you the support of the organization. Once again, it's the most important fundraising event of the year. It keeps all of our programs alive, whether it's the Shirim, or the Teen Division, or the Parsha Paper, or the Magazine, or the Women's Division, or the Media's Division, or the Torah Writers, or whatever other programs that we have. The many dozen programs that we have brought Hashem. So that's that regarding announcements. At this time, it's my honor and privilege to call upon a man that has literally inspired hundreds and thousands of people. Rabbi Yosef Chaim Schwab was the son of the renowned Rabbi Shimon Schwab, the Rabbi is also Rabbi Eddie Shuzor Smith. It's a big privilege for us to have him in our community. Let's give a nice loud round of applause to our Rabbi Yosef Chaim Schwab.
Thank you, Nat Yaniv. Shalom Aleichem. Good evening. Chazaq. Chazaq means be strong. Chizuk, you need strength to be a Torah Jew. Let's see what we have to talk about tonight. What should we talk about? Well, tonight is already Yom Shishi, Friday, so it's Erev Rosh Chodesh Elul. And Motzi Shabbat is the first day of the month of Elul. And then comes for Sfardim Slichot, not for us yet. That needs Chizuk, 5 o'clock in the morning. That takes a lot of courage. You have to be strong for that. It's very hard. First of all, let me thank Torah Anytime that's putting us on the air. My friend Shimon Kolyakov, who founder of it, and Reuven Kolyakov, and the director Yosef Davis of Torah Anytime. They have awful lot of exposure in the world. You know how much? Let me tell you. Torah Anytime, I told Shimon Kolyakov years ago, should not be T-A-T, it should be T-N-T, dynamite. 35,000 shiurim. 6 million hours. 120 countries. About 300 Magide Shir, I'm one of them. I have about 400 videos. And it costs them money monthly to run this, you know, where you have to give your tzedakah in the month of Elul. How do I get here tonight? I get here because of one man, this man right here. Binyamin Shamsiev came to Muncie. He's my Talmud Muvhok. He listens to every shiur, even the one I put on today. Some people have the fortune to have a Talmud Muvhok, who's your real Talmud. Thank you, Shimon. And he told Yaniv, and that's why we're on the air, and Torah Anytime, the carrier, all over the world. I'm on Kol HaLashon also, which is not video, only audio. About 3,200 shiurim on that also, every day. This I do once a week. And Chazaq is one of the Kirov organizations in America. There's Torah Anytime, that's Torah Anytime too. There's Kol HaLashon, Partners in Torah, Ura, Inspire, Dirshu, Or Sameach. Nobody can beat Torah Anytime because Reuven and Shimon are the biggest Rosh Hashivas in the world. They bring Torah to 120 countries. 35,000 shiurim, 6 million hours. There's no one greater than that. I'm glad to be a part of Torah Anytime. So now what do we talk about? Okay, Elul, Slichot, Rosh Hashanah, Aser Semei Tshuva, Yom Kippur. We have a tall order they gave me to do this in 45 minutes. I don't know how I'm going to do it. Let's start with the theme of Chazak. For Slichos, you got to be strong. Early in the morning, we Ashkenazim only do it, the minimum is 4 days. This year it's a week, because you have to have 4 days before Rosh Hashanah, minimum, because the carbon you have to check out for 4 days, see if it's a mum or a cripple, and we're carbonos. We're offering ourselves up to Hashem, please accept us. And the maximum could be 8 days, like this year, because Rosh Hashanah is on Sunday night, Monday. You have to have 4 days of that week, so we don't. We have one, so we go the week before. So it's 4 or 8 days, but Sfardim is much, they're much stronger. They do it for a month. I don't know how they do it. A Sfardi once told me years ago in Or Sameach, I love to be a Sfardi in Nisan and in Av, but not in Elul. And you understand why. Let's start with Elul. Elul, if you know a little gematria, is Aleph Lamed Vav Lamed, 67. Yes, so. Well, Mispar Katan, you add the digits. 6 and 7 is 13. 1 and 3 is 4. Yud Kei Vav Kei is 4. Hashem has rachamim for you in this month. He wants, he'll overlook certain things if you do tshuva. Elul is the time of rachamim. There's a system of gematrias where you numbers have deep Kabbalistic meanings. Elul is 13, before you break it down to 4. Do you know what that means? What do you think this has this? Why do you get up early sleepers? What do you think? Why? What? To learn more Torah. That's all. And then you become a better person if you keep the Torah, you know what's going on. Don't we say before Baruch Shomar every single day, Bishmul Amrova, Shlosha Essay Dvarim, 13 things the Torah is dash in 13 different ways, Kavachomer and Gezer Shava, Vishlosha Essay Midas HaTorah Nidroshes. Ah, Talmud Torah, you need to, when you learn Gemara, you go through the 13 mental processes of deduction and critical analysis. So Rabbi Shmuel Amar Shlosh Ezemidos, 13 ways you dash in Torah. No, that's what you're supposed to do in Elul. Just does not get up. So what? You get up, said Slichot, so? That means the davening after Slichot should be slower and deeper and more concentrated, a better davening. And when you come into a shul, some shuls have on top, Da lifnei miyat omei, do you know for whom you're, in front of whom you're standing? And then some shuls says, some shuls have on top of the article, Avina Makenu, Pesach Shari Shemaim Letfilaseinu, open up my heart, I'm asking you, let me have some feeling. Then I'll become automatically a better Jew. Chazak means be strong and fight off the Yetzer Hara. Chazak is 115. Chof, Zayin, 8, 7, and 100. 115. You add the digits, it's 7. When you're strong, you are Kadosh, because everything in Yiddishkeit about Kadosh is 7. Here I have a pamphlet I once made. 49 sevens. Everything in the Torah is 7. Give you an example. 7 days of Sfira. Shabbos is the 7th day. 7 days of Pesach, 2nd day of 7th day of Sukkot. Yovel is 7 times 7. Shemitah is 7. Avelus is 7 days. 7 names for Yisro's daughters, and for Yushalayim, and for Harsina, and for Moshe Rabbeinu. Moshe was born on, died on the 7th of Adar. And Sukkot, you have the 7 Ushpizin, the guests. 7 branches of the menorah. Achashverus made a party for Esther for 7 days. After the 180-day party. 7 Yom Tovim, Pesach, Sukkot, Shavuos, Rosh Hashanah, Yom Kippur, Chanukah, and Purim. 7 mitzvot Rabbanan. 7 mitzvot B'nei Noach. 7 brachas at a wedding, 7 brachas. 7 heavens. On Shabbos, you got to call a minimum of 7 people to the Torah. First pasuk in the Torah, 7 words. Bereishis, Bara, Lekim, Eitz, Shemayim, Eitz, Oretz. 7 days, Chanukah Sam Mizbeach, to dedicate the Mizbeach. The Kala walks around the Chosin 7 times. Ritzuas on the arm tefillin, 7. The plagues in Egypt lasted 7 days. Paro saw a dream of 7 cows and 7 sheaves of corn. Tumas Meis, you have to wait 7 days to be Tohar. Klal Yisrael waited for Miriam 7 days. Everything is 7. 7 brachas on Shabbos. First 3, last 3, and the one in the middle. 7. Weekday is 19. Shivas Aminim. There's 2 grains and 5 fruits in Eretz Yisrael. Every single thing, if you think about it, if Kedusha is 7. Noach waited 7 days before he sent out the second bird. Rosh Hashanah. 7th month. First day. 7 leap years in a 19-year cycle of the sun. Shiach has 7 names. A Kohen is obligated to get Tomei to his 7 closest relatives. Not a Kohen Gadol, a regular Kohen. For a woman, 7 Nikiyim. 7 Akofis on Hashanah Rabbah. Yeshua went on Yericho 7 times. On the 7th day, he blew the shofar 7 times, and the walls sunk down like an elevator. Not collapsed, they sunk. I walked on those walls 30 years ago around Yericho when I could still go there. Minimum size of a sukkah, 7 by 7 tefachim. Yaakov worked for Leah 7 years and 7 years for the other one. 7 nevios, Sarah, Miriam, Devorah, Hannah, Abigail, Huldah, Esther, Devorah. Eved Ivri works 6 years and gets free on the 7th. You say Hashem Huldah Kim after Yom Kippur 7 times. Oh, we could go one. Seven nations in Canaan, one ran away, so they destroyed six nations. Emet Sora has to wait 7 days, and then 7 days, and then 7 days. Light, Nair's 250. How much is 2 and 5? 7. You can keep on going. I published it. It's on Torah anytime. It's called the 49-7. I didn't even tell you all the 49s. Where is that? Right here. Put this away. So, you know, Torah anytime and the other station I'm on, called Elushim, this very big Kiev organ, it worked. They speak in 10, 12 languages. Yiddish, English, Hebrew, French, Spanish, Russian, Torah. Russian, Farsi, Bukharian, German, Dutch, Portuguese, Finnish, Hungarian. There's no excuse for a person not to learn nowadays. No. So, we finished Elul. And Slichos, I told you. When you come into a shul, look at the words, Da, lifnei mi atomei. Not the Slichos, is only introduction to the davening. So you daven better and deeper and slower. Now, my father Zatzal had a fabulous idea. If you do certain averos, certain terrible averos, there's 36 terrible averos where you get kores, but you can save yourself. And in the time of Moshe Rabbeinu and after Yeshua, there was ir mikla. If you kill somebody by accident, you go to the ir mikla, there's klita there, no one can touch you. You can stay there until the Kohen Gadol dies, then you can leave. Six ir mikla. Three on this side, three on that side. My father said, what do you do nowadays if you killed yourself? That means you did a virus that destroys your neshama. I don't want to mention them, very terrible things. I'll tell you some of the easier ones. Eating chametz on Pesach, akazayas. Eating on Yom Kippur, akazayas. Eating chaylev adam, chas v'sholem boil nido. There's 36 things. You can save yourself. So a person kills somebody. Yeah, I know it was an accident, but why it was you? Why wasn't it him or him or him? Hashem, he wants to punish you a little bit, so you run away into the ir mikla. There are six ir miklas. My father said, today we also have six. What's the six things where you can save your life if you killed yourself, your neshama? Yeah, we say it every day. Six words. Shema Yisrael, Hashem Elokeinu, Hashem Echad. That's your refuge. And then there was 42 more cities with the six cities of Mikla. The Hafta has exactly 42 words. Interesting concept. You can save your life by going to the Mikla. It means returning to Hashem. Go back and do tshuva. And you know, you teach a child the first pasuk when he speaks Shema Yisrael, and the last pasuk when you're about to go, Shema Yisrael Hashem HaKen Hashem HaChod. That's your Mikla, that's your refuge. Attach yourself with the Eternal One. You also will be eternal. Everyone wants to live forever. We do, over there. When you say Kriya Shema, you hold the tzitzis. All four of them, in your finger, between these two fingers, on your heart. When you get to the third parsha, you take out the front two only, and you say the parsha tzitzis. Why the front two only? Because five knots and eight strings is 13, and this is 13 is 26, yud kei vav kei. Hashem not only told you to believe in him, he told you the third pasha too. Belief is nothing unless you do the mitzvahs. You can't just be a believer, a total monotheist, but you're mechal Shabbos, they put you to death. You can't do all the mitzvahs and not believe in God, you're a kofer, you're an atheist. You have to have theory and practice. That's why we hold it tzitzis, which is, because Hashem is the same Yud Kei Vav Kei who gave the theory and gave the practice. Yiddishkeit without mitzvahs is nothing. And how you know how to do the mitzvahs? You have to learn Torah. For that you need chizuk, strength. So there's 613 mitzvahs, right? 248 positive, 365 negative. 613 mitzvahs. What if you add 613, what do you get? Seres HaDibros, 10. And if you say, leave out the zero and just one, get Hashem. He gave the Seres HaDibros. There's 170 words in the Seres HaDibros. 170 words. How much is 172? Bingo. 10. 1. It all comes from one source. Now, Anochi we're talking about, right? The whole Torah is concentrated in the Seres HaDibros. By the way, the Seres HaDibros doesn't exist in the Torah. There's not one place in the Torah you find the word the Seres HaDibros. Yeah, Rashi talks about it, Gemara, the Mishnah, but the Seres HaDibros does not exist in the Chumash because it's not Hebrew. You can't say a male and a female together. A Seres is male, Dibros is female. You can't do that. So the Torah calls it a Seres HaDvarim. That's Zohar and Zohar. You can do that. But in Aramaic, it's different. A Seres HaDibros doesn't exist in the Torah. So I have about 10 words that don't exist in the Torah. Talis and Tefillin doesn't exist. Esther, Lulav, Hadassah, Merov doesn't exist. Eretz Yisrael doesn't exist. Yerushalayim doesn't exist in the Torah. Isn't that interesting? Which words don't exist? There's a reason for that. If I told you everything, we'd be here till 11 o'clock at night. Let's take a look at the parasha. Re'ei Anochi. We're talking about the Seres HaDibros, right? Let's see what it says in this week's parasha. Exactly what Slichos is all talking about. We are talking about Re'ei Anochi, see, I, Nosein Lefneichem, giving before you, Hayom, Brachol Klola. You have a choice. Okay, that's a simple explanation. Now let's get a little deeper. You want to hear a gigantic little secret of the Torah? Re'ei, look at Anochi Hashem Elokecha. Go back to Seres HaDibros. Then you know everything. If you added Anochi, you would get the certain word 91, which is Amen. I agree with everything. It goes very deep. You have to listen to my shiurim, daily shiurim and kol haloshon. I have 3,200 of them. It's going on for 8 years. It's the number, one number for America. It's not the New York branch. It's the original branch in Bnei Barak. And it's when I make a drasha, second later is archived already. I can play it back. The number is 718-395-2440. Because there's one in New York. I'm not on that one. 718-395-2440. So when you get there, you got 300 people. How do you get me? You got to dial my PIN number, 11101. Then you get all the parshas. 8 years reviewed. The last one is the last one. And they have also 11104 for all the Megillus and all the Yom Tovim, a different number. And my father saved for another one, and all the Haftorahs, another one. I keep busy. Okay. Re Anochi, look at Anochi. I'm giving you today Baruchah V'Klal, a choice, free choice. Es HaBaruchah Asher Tishmun, the Baruchah, if you listen. El Mitzvos Hashem Elokechem, to the mitzvahs of God, your God. Asher Anochi Mitzavach Hayom, that I'm commanding you today. V'Klal and the curse, Im Lo Tishmun, if you do not listen. Es El HaMitzvos, about to the mitzvahs. Hashem Elokechem, Sartim and Aderech, you stray just a little bit. You know what happens? Shenochi Mitzavach Hayom, the Lachas, eventually you go after other gods. Really? You change one little thing, you could be out of worship. Not you, your grandkids. What do you think they started in 1775, the deformed religion? They just change a little minhag, Gehenem and minhag, same letters. You change a little, yeah, you did a little. The next one goes further and further until the kids convert to be goyim. They said the temple had music on Shabbat, so we'll get a goy to play the harp. That's why every reformed temple is called a temple, not a synagogue. My little child once, when he was 8 years old, he said, hey, what's that, Tati? I said, that's a reformed temple. We don't go in there. They don't keep the Torah. He looks at me, he says, why do you call it a temple? They should call it sin against God. Little kid, 8 years old, synagogue, sin against God. I said, they never went to yeshiva. Maybe they'll be Baal Shuvas one day. I know them, they're nice people, but very nice people. I taught Reformed Jews for years. I told them, you're wonderful people, you didn't go to yeshiva. If you went, you'd probably be better than me. But your philosophy is a lie. Your shita is sheker. The Torah is min hashamayim, not like your people told you. The Talmud is not for primitive people, like they said. It's for most brilliant people, like Abaye and Rava and Rabbi Akiva. Liars and deniers. They don't mean, I'm not against them. Personally, I teach them. The shita is krum, it's sheker. It's Kfira. It's apikoresis. They're wonderful people because they never learn. You expect a four-year-old to know algebra? Why? Why would you want to expect a third grader to know geometry? You never taught them anything. So now we have this bracha. Why is this a bracha? It's a bracha shir tishma that you will listen, but the klola im if you don't listen. How come by the bracha it says a bracha asher tishmu that you will listen, and the klola means if you don't. You know what Rabbi is saying? If you decide to listen to Torah, regardless how much you know or how much you understand, but you say, listen, my grandfather, great grandfather are not fools. Rashi, Rambam, Moshe Rabbeinu, and Avraham and Yaakov. I don't know much about it, but I believe it. And I'm going to do the right there thing. The bracha is that you already decided to listen. That's already the bracha. That's why it says, Esta bracha, asher that you listen. Asher tishmu, aleph top, from beginning to end. You can take the whole thing. I may not understand it, but I know it's right. Because this is a winning, this yahadus is a winning thing. How you know? Because Avram was born in 1948. That's 4,000 years ago. Now it's 57, 75. That's 3,800 years ago, 3950. And we're here. And the Canaanim are not here, and the Philistines are not here, and the Romans are not here, the unholy Roman Empire is not here, and the Pelishtim, and the Babylonians, and the Spanish, and Nazism, and communism founded by Jews. Because they were so poor, they wanted everyone to be equal. Yosefska, that's the original Russian movement founded by Jews, who never, desperate people, poor. Only Israel is hated by everybody. We're public enemy number one. We're very proud about that. Because we never forced anyone to be like the Christians did or the Muslims. No, you do yours. Don't leave me alone. I'm only one half of 1% of humanity. Why are you bothering me? My country is so small you can hardly see it. We are the biggest threat to mankind. Hitler said that. Haman said that. Because we are bringing the message of Hashem, they don't want to hear it. But the end of Aleinu, we say every day they will hear it. But Yom Mahu Yashem Chodesh Mochad, they will hear it. It'll make sense. So we took care of the parasha of the week. Now, let us learn a little bit of Hilchas Tshuva from the Rambam, because this is what we're getting into. Elul Tshuva. Now, what do you think the Shlichus is for? Let's learn the famous fifth parak of the Rambam Hilchas Tshuva. Let's see how do we do this Tshuva thing. Rishus l'chol adam, every human being, didn't say Israel, every human being nit nesuna is given permission. Imrotza, if he wants to. Lahatos atzmo lederech tova, to go to the correct way, and God has told mankind what the direct way is, because out of the 613, seven mitzvah b'nei Noach, so they know exactly what they have to do, and we know what we have to do. Lios tzadik, harshus b'yolo, you have permission to be, you can be a tzadik. Imrotz alatos atzmo lederech ro'o, if you decide to be immoral, rotten, crook, thief, cheat, Russia. The Yos Rosh Arshus Piyano, you have a Rishus, you may be very much Sliach too. Who should call the Torah? Hein Ha'odom, Hoyo Echad Mimenu. The Moroccan said about Adam and Chava, hey, they're going to be one of us. They know the difference between Tov and Ra. Eitz Hadas only told them good. Didn't say Ra, but they did a Chet. Adam and Chava did a Chet. Now she knows what Ra is, go against Hashem. Hashem never wanted you to know about Ra. Tov is good enough. What do you have to know of the evil? What do you have to... She wanted to eat from the Eitz Hadas, and he seduced her to Satan. Kiloma, hein min zeshel adam, this species called man, he's unique. The only living creature that can talk. Even a minor bird and a parrot doesn't talk. He teaches the same word 500 times, and it says, good morning! When it's 11 o'clock at night. Only human beings can speak because we have an neshama. There is no other creature in the world that has a neshama and can speak. Only man. He knows that we know the difference between Tov and Ra. You can do whatever you want in this world. no one's going to stop you. Never. Nobody can stop you if you want to do evil. You have free choice, 100%. Kiven shekein hu pen yishlach yodo. Maybe he'll grab his hand and grab the Eitz HaChayim. So Hashem said, get him out of Gan Eden, because they'll live forever. Can't do that once you did a chet. Don't entertain for a minute. Tovar says, Shomrim, this thing that they say, Tipshe Umas Om, the fools of the nations of the world, the great philosophers. For Rov Gulmabinis, and most Jews who don't learn Torah, from Jews who don't learn Torah, they think, if God let me be a Rasha, then it must be His will. And if I'm Matzliach, living a life of Chet, and I'm Matzliach, it must be His will. Don't believe people say things like that. God goes as decrees on a man, before he's born. The Yos Sadik or Russia. That's what they say. They think that. Chas v'shalom. We have Bechira Chavshis, total free choice. Everything before you're born is decided. Who you're going to marry, how long you're going to live, how many kids you're going to have, how rich you're going to be, how poor you're going to be. Everything. How tall you're going to be, and well, how sick you're going to be. Everything. Except one area, Hashem never entered that arena. That's called free choice. Because if He would urge you in any way to be good or bad, so if you're good, why should you get a reward? And if He urge you to be bad, why should you be punished? Free choice, completely. And if you'll say, well, I'm a Chalal Shabbat, I eat Reifot, look, God doesn't strike me down dead. Fool! He wants you to do what you want to do, because at the end, He's waiting. And there's an end. Every religion has that concept. Ain Hadover Cain, it's not like that. That God made me evil, made me good, gave me this drive. He may have given you a drive, but you can't practice it if it's evil. Ain Hadover Cain, Ella Kol Adam Roy Leo Tzadik Moshe Rabbeinu. Every single person, man or woman, could be a tzadik like Moshe Rabbeinu. Oh, Rosh Ki Yeravam Ben Nevat. Why did you pick these two people? Why don't you say Moshe and Esau? Moshe and Korach. Moshe and Menashe. Moshe and anybody. Dosen and Aviram. Why Yeravam Ben Nevat? The first melech of Malchi Yisrael. You know why? Moshe knew the Torah perfect, and so did Yeravam ben Nevat. Torah so shall Yeravam ain bodofi. There was no fault in his Torah. He knew everything. How could he be such a Rasha, Yeravam ben Nevat? He put up an eagle in the north, and they had, if you want to go down three times a year to Yerushalayim, you had to go through a certain path that has a low bar. You had to bow down to the eagle, so people didn't go. That's Yeravam ben Nevat, who had the greatest Torah knowledge in the world. And he put one in Be'er Sheva, couldn't come up to Yerushalayim because he also had to bend down. How could you be so bright and so wicked? Korach, Moshe's first cousin, carried the Aron on his shoulders. And his tent is called Mishkan Korach, not Ohel. He had Ruch, he had Shechina. How could he be said to me? He said, Moshe, you're a fraud. Moshe, God never spoke to you, otherwise you wouldn't have all the sorrows here. Water and mud and sloth and rem. People want to go back to the shrine. They want to overthrow you. You're a fraud. So Moshe said, I didn't want this job. I argued for 7 days. At the snare, I don't want this job. I was forced. And if you don't do tshuva, the ground's going to open up and you're going to go get swallowed in the ground. I don't care. I'm convinced I'm right. So the ground starts shaking. He said, Korach, you got a few seconds, step away. No! And he was the only man in the world that died alive. Chaim Sheola. What does that mean? We don't even know, Korach. Died alive? Chaim? How do you do that? How do you die alive? Chaim Sheola. These are all deep subjects. Talking about a very great mind who went off to Derech. That's why you get a unique punishment. Two sons of Aaron, Eish Zora, instant death. There were tzaddikim who made one misstep. If you're a big tzaddik, you get immediately punished. If if you're in Russia and you do another Aveira, so what? If you have a dirty suit and you have another dirty mark here, so. But if you're at Tzaddik and you wear a white tuxedo and there's a little blue mark here, it's finished, ruined, over. Big Tzaddikim, one mistake ruins them because they're so great. So go further. Hadover ze ikar gadol, this is a very big ikar in Yahadus. To know free choice is up to you. Hashem never will urge me in no way. So look, you say, come on, please. Yaakov and Esau, please. Esau, from the youth, he was programmed that way. What do you blame Esau for? What do you blame a person whose mother and father are dope addicts and gangsters? What do you expect from the kid? Of course he's going to be in a gang when he's 8 years old. And another person comes from a father where he's a doctor and a lawyer and wealthy. And of course he's going to go to college and be a mensch. How do you blame your program like that from youth? Don't you see, well, answer is, don't you see people that come from the finest family and they go off to derech? And you come people who have the worst background to become tzaddikim. Havdil elef havdolos. A man walked 8 miles to school every morning. He became president of the United States, Abraham Lincoln. They asked him once, Mr. President Lincoln, whose side you on, North or South, during the Civil War? He said, that's not the proper question. The proper question is, whose side is God on? That's why he was president, because he was a great human being. I've given you today Hayom Brachu Klola, like it says in Ray. You have a free choice, any one of you, every one of you, every single day of your life. Should I eat this and look at this and think about this? Or should I not? All the decisions are in your mind, and no one knows who's a Rosho really and who's a Tzaddik really. You put on a nice show. We all put on a nice show. How do you know what you're really dealing with? So the Gemara says you can find out three ways. Kiso, kaso, bakoso. Kiso, kiss his pocket. What kind of business does he run? How was he making money? Kiso. Kaso, when he gets a little annoyed, does he watch his mouth or does he embarrass people? Koso, how does he drink? Does he overindulge? That's how you can tell the person. Kiso, kaso, bakoso. Not what he says in public and not what he writes books. Let's see how he lives. Okay. And then he says, you have to make a distinction between a shota and a tipish. A shota is not your fault. You're born that way. Cheresh, shota, v'kotn is part of the whole Torah. Cheresh, deaf, you don't hear Shema Yisrael, so you're not chayav. Shota, you're imbecile, not your fault. And cotton, you're below 13, not, you're not chayav. But a tipish means you don't understand, you're smart, but you do stupid things called tipish, turn it around, is show fate. You're going to be judged. You know it's wrong. That's why you're a fool. You're that kind of a fool. Tipesh, you know what's right, because shofet, you're going to be, you know it's, you're going to be judged by a, in mishpat, by a shofet. That's why you're a tipesh. A shofet is not your fault. He said the people who think that you're programmed to be good or bad are tipshim, fools. You're not programmed to be anything. You could be anything you want to be. Moshe Rabbeinu or Yerubim Ben Avot. Shema Tomer, last piece. Lest you say, Hello, HaKadosh Baruch Hu Yodeya. He knows, Kol Mashiyo, everything is going to happen. If you're going to turn out to be a Rosho or Tzaddik, he knows it beforehand, before you make the choice. HaKadosh Yodeya, before you do it, he knows what you're going to do. If you will make the choice or not the right choice. Shezei Yiyat Tzaddik or Rosho, he knows that. But he doesn't, like, you know what it's like? I have 10 little kids here, all 4 years old, 5 years old, 6 years old, 3 years old. And I hold lollipops in front of them. 7 different colors. One is red. It's known that 90% will take the red. I know that ahead of time. 90%. That's we know. Hashem knows what you're going to do, but it doesn't influence you at all, ever. But since he knows the future, he knows what you're going to do, but he never will influence you. You have total, complete to be whatever you want to be. He knows what you're going to be at the end, but he will not influence you. That's not, I know that kid's going to pick red 90%. I'm not influencing him, I'm not saying a word. inquiry. And now, since we learned Hilchos Teshuva, what about that great Haftorah between Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur? Shuva Yisrael, return Yisrael. Ad Hashem Elokecha, that's what Elul is about. Until you get to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, total tshuva, complete. Turn around, I'm going the wrong derech, go the other way. Every one of us are adults. We know exactly what we're not doing right. We're not naive. We know every single thing. You cannot daven in 25 minutes, shachris. That's just impossible, but it means you skip every word, other word. You have to say each word, and if you don't have time, you cut out certain things, but those pieces you say it without skipping them, the ikrim at least. Certain things you've got to say, you can't skip. Or come 10 minutes earlier, 20 minutes earlier, and all you have to daven with a minyan is Shimon Esa. Not even Shema, only Shema Esa, you got to daven with a minyan. Everything else you can say before. Shuvi Yisrael, return Yisrael. Came from the Rambam, yeah. Shuva Yisrael, Ad Hashem Elokecha. Kechu Yimachim Devarim, take with you words. Shuva El Hashem. Six words. Shema. Kechu Yimachim Devarim, Shuva El Hashem. That's the Ikar of Yadus. Shema Yisrael, listen. Listen well, not with here, with your brain. Shem Elokeinu Shemachad. He made everything. He's here before. You were here, is now, and will be in the future. Everything in the Torah is Emes. Because he made the world and the creation. And all the inventions that people come up 5,000 years later, he already had it programmed. He already gave people intelligence how to make a cell phone. It was, the power was there, they just didn't have it till 30 years, 20 years ago. The Wright brothers made the airplane. I know, the ability to do it was there 5,000 years ago. And a car instead of a horse. And a spacecraft. It's all been there. If people were bigger tzaddikim, they would have discovered this thousands of years ago. And now, let us go a little further. Chazak needs strength, right? Get up early in the morning, learn Torah every 3 minutes. Who is stronger, men or women? Of course, everybody knows the answer. Women. How do you know that? I'll give you some tremendous examples. You know why we got out of Mitzrayim? It says in the Gemara, "Bishvil Noshin Sitkanios Nikalu Avaseinim Mitzrayim," because of the righteous women. You know who have the greatest chokhma? Women. Chokhmas Noshim Bonso Beisa. She builds the home. You know who have the greatest bina understanding? Bina yaseira nostu the nashim, to women. You know who have more emuna? Vatikach Miriam and all the women took tof, these tambourines, Adam and Sraim, and they're going to play them when the Yamsuf will split. But the Bnei Yisrael didn't believe that it would split until they saw the dead Mitzrayim. Then Vayamina Bashem Amoshavdo, but the women did that before. How do you know they have a higher neshama? Because the midwives in Mitzrayim, when Pharaoh told them to kill every child when it's only partial birth abortion, when the face is up, it's a girl, let it live. If the face is down, it's a boy, kill it. Partial birth abortion. Yeah, that's what they're doing today. Murder, says in the Bereishis, second chapter there, you kill a human being inside of a human being. Abortion is asr for every guy. Those doctors that do abortion, when Mashiach comes, they're the first to be publicly executed. No guy can do this. There's a few Rushayim in the world, they have titles. Kill a human being. I don't want the child. You should watch yourself. Behave yourself. You wouldn't have to have this problem. You're the chet. Not always, but 90% of the time. So, women come from a man who has a neshama. Right? Is that Kabbalah? And man comes from the earth. So she's higher, and we're lower. Now, does that mean that we are losers, men? We're second class? Absolutely not. Totally equal. How is that possible? I just told you. Sitkanyos, Chokma, Bino, Emuno, they have a higher neshama because it came from a human being who had a neshama already. Adam, Hashem split them, took out their Isha, and then a man comes from the Ofer Meldoma. I'll tell you in a minute why we are equal. But let me tell you a name of some women who are greater than their husband. Let's start with someone I'm sure you heard about. It's called Sarah. Avram said, Nishi Shmuel, I can make him Baal Tshuva. Sarah says, throw him out of the house. And Hashem tells Avram, Shema B'kola, listen to her. She's right, you're wrong. And the Mor Nevuchim says, in chapter Membeis, you'll look it up, she was in 11th Madrega of Nevuah, he was the 10th. Listen to her, she's right, you're wrong. Get rid of him, out of the house. The father's in Avram, the major Baal Tshuva man. Not him. Yeah, maybe outside the house, but not with Yitzchok. You ever heard of Rivka? She tricked her husband. After marrying 20 years, they had a son. Yeah, Yaakov, when he was 60 years old, which means Yitzchok got married at 40, had a child at 60. When Yaakov was 60, he was 120. She dressed up Yaakov like Esav, tricked her husband, and he says, oh, you're Esav? Your voice don't sound like him. Your hair doesn't feel like him. But Rivka did El Shem Shemaim, fooled her husband. And then when Esav walked in, he says, who are you? He says, well, I'm Esav, but who was the one that came before you? Ooh, then Yaakov, Yitzchak realized his wife finally, because as soon as Esav walked in, Yitzchak shook a hand and opened up in front of him. When Yaakov walked in, Gan Eden, smelled like Gan Eden because he's wearing Esav's clothes that he took from Adam from Gan Eden. So he says, Gam Baruch Yeh, that one that I blessed, let him stay blessed. I see that I was fooled by this Esav, Hoy Shav, how false was he? Remember, Yitzchak was blind, he couldn't see. That's why he got fooled. So Rivka saved the Jewish people. Sarah, Rivka, let's go to Rachel. Rachel was supposed to be the one that Yaakov married, love and tricked him. And Leah, she didn't want to embarrass Leah on the wedding night. She told her the secrets that Yaakov told Rachel, and they told it to Leah because he knew that he may do that, love may trick him. And she gave up to be the first mother of Klal Yisrael. That's why millions of people go to Cave of Rachel. Not that many go to Cave of Maris Machpelah, where Leah is. Rachel gave up the chance to be the first mother of Israel. This is Rachel Imenu. That's how great she was. Leah, she had six boys, half of the 12. And even though her husband didn't love her as much, it says, Ki sanua Leah, she was hated. Chas v'sholem, you're not allowed to be with a woman who hates, means only 99% in love with her. That's called sanua. Women are very sensitive to this. And she stayed with him anyhow, because that's Ratzon Hashem. And she was buried next to him in Maris Machpelah. I know Rachel's in Kever Rachel, but millions of people go to her. So it comes out equal. Let's go further. Zipporah saved her husband Moshe from dying. When the Sultan came to swallow up Moshe in the hotel, she took a flint and mauled her Eliezer. And then the Sultan went away and didn't swallow Moshe. Zipporah. Esther, because of her, we have Purim. Matisyahu's sister, Yehudis, we have Hanukkah. Yael put a stake in the guy's head, in Sisera's head. And that's how Israel beat that nation. So men are inferior, right? Not exactly. Let's take a look. Chas v'sholem. Women are born with certain qualities, inborn. That's where they're born. We just told you. When you get something free, if you don't work for it, you could easily lose it. If you're born with a silver spoon in your mouth, you could easily lose it. Men have to work very hard. We have to go to shul 3 times a day. We have to daven. We have to learn every few minutes. We have to get up for slichas. It's so hard. Talmud Torah. Women not mechuyev to learn over and over and over and over and over and over the same thing. If a man's 80 years old, why is he learning the same Gemara again? Shulchan Aruch. He learned it already 50 times. Talmud Torah purifies the neshama. You don't learn it. You know all the knowledge. Just learn it because it's a mitzvah to learn. Women cannot do that. Women have chokhmah, which is, what is this? And women has bina, How does it work? They don't have das. Why is it that it's like that? Why is batul b'shishim? Why 60-1? Why not 70-1? Or 80-1? Or 40-1? That's not their department. Why? That's Kabbalah already. Why is the blood blue here and come out red? Why in the Nachalas zone, where you make tzitzis, the tcheles, it's red and comes out blue? And that sheretz you use for a mitzvah? It's Kabbalah. That's for men to get involved. Therefore, men can be the dayanim and the posting in Rosh Hashivas and Gedolim, not the women. They know practical Yiddishkeit. A man has to know, why is the grass green and the guy sky blue? Why not the other way around? Why does the Torah start with Bereshis? Not why. Why doesn't it start with Bereshon or Borlikim? Women don't have that. That's not their thing. They're very practical people. They build a home. They know how to keep a family together. They don't have to know why the grass is green and the sky is blue. That's the secrets of the Torah. We get involved in that. Different. Only a man can be a posig and a dayan and a Rosh Yeshiva and a Baal Korah and a Baal Tekeah. So we're 100% equal. Ezer, helper, kenegdo, your partner. You need the opposite. That's how it works. Perfect match. Now, one more step. Rosh Hashanah. Why is it not the first day of the first month? Why is it the first day of the seventh month? Well, Tishrei is the first month, but Tishrei is the seventh month. It's the first month of the creation of the world. That is true. But it's the seventh month. It started from Nisan, the Jewish calendar and holiday cycle. That's something else. So the Torah says on the first day of the seventh month, you're being judged. Because Adam Arishon was made on Rosh Hashanah. Friday was the sixth day of the seventh. Friday was Tishrei Aleph. By the way, Bereshis, the word Bereshis, if you take play with the letters, Ber Aleph Tishrei. So if the world was created and Adam was made on Aleph Tishrei, how come it says in the Torah, the Kodesh Hashvi'im, Be'echel HaKodesh, Yom Teruah Yelechem. And what do you call Yom Teruah? Why not Yom Tekiyah? Never. He says you have to blow tekiyahs, and you're going to blow tekiyahs, but when you... But it says in the Torah, Yom Teruah Yelechem. What's the difference? Ooh, a world of a difference. You know what tekiyah difference is? You know why the Torah calls Rosh Hashanah Yom Teruah? Tekiyah is every day of your life. Look at Rachel. God is calling you. Look at the Sefer. He's calling you. Talk to a Talmud Chacham. He speaks to you. Every day he's calling you. Once a year, you have to answer. Teruah, we break down in tears. Yes, I'm sorry. He calls you every day. When do you answer? Rosh Hashanah. Yom Teruah Yelechem. Lachem, I'm waiting for your answer. The key is every day. Yom Teruah Yelechem, when are you going to answer me? Teruah, the breakdown, that means yearning, crying, you know, you're sorry for, then, so you blow tekiyah, call, shvarim, or shvarim teruah, and you break down and you say, I'm sorry Hashem, you're right, and then tekiyah, I accept it. That's why it's called Yom Teruah Yelechem. The day when we answer once a year, he's waiting for you all your life. When you get up in the morning and say Slichot, you're answering his call. It's hard to get up 5 o'clock in the morning. Men are very strong in a one way, and women are very strong in another way. We are 100% equal. Because when you learn Torah and work for it, it's very hard for you to give it up. Women born with these extra advantages, but it's easy to lose it if you didn't work for it. If a man worked for it, it's usually not going to lose it, so it comes out equal. Now you have Rosh Hashanah. We talked about the first month, the seventh month, Yom Teruah Yelechem. Now you have a Seder Shemei Tshuva. Doesn't exist. Can't be 10, because you're not allowed to do Tshuva in Rosh Hashanah. So 2 days off, and Shabbat Tshuva, no, so you only have 7. How do you call the Seder Shemei Tshuva? On Shoshana, you never say Vidoi, Katushon, Lashamnu, Achei. No, never on Rosh Hashanah you don't. No vidui at all. How you call it service to make tshuva? Even Eretz Yisrael 2 days. The Shabbos tshuva in the middle, you can't do tshuva on the Shabbos. It's only 7. But they call it chaser to make tshuva. Let me tell you what the Gemara tells us. There is a type of tshuva that we do Rosh Hashanah, is recognize who you're doing tshuva to. Hashem Malkechem, God is your king. Ah! They, Avinu Malkeinu, you are the boss. You run the show. You gave me life. I have to respect my father and mother, even if they're not from Shomer Shabbos. They gave me life. I have to respect my mother and my father. I don't care how religious they are. They gave me life. I could, Baruch Hashem, they don't have what I have, but they gave me life, otherwise I wouldn't be here. You have to give cover to your father and your mother. Es Savicha, even your stepmother. Es Imecha, even your stepfather. And your older brother, and your Rebbe. S means to anybody that represents authority. So a seris to make tshuva on Rosh Hashanah is the godless, the romamus of his malchus, that he is the melech malchim lochim. And then the other 7 days you do vidui and vitzlichos and rashamdu and alchet, and Yom Kippur is the maximum all day. So you have Rosh Hashanah, even Eretz Yisrael is 2 days, even though in the Torah is 1 day. And then you have Yom Kippur. So Rosh Hashanah, if you had Tzadik Gomor by the time the Slichos are over 30 days, by the time you get to Rosh Hashanah, if you're at Tzadik Gomor, you signed up first minute Rosh Hashanah for Yigan Eden. If you're a Rosh, you're signed up for Gehenna. This is for Tzadik Gomor and Rosh Gomor. Let's say you're not a Tzadik Gomor, you're not a Rosh Gomor, so you have 10 days to fix it. This is for Beinonim. So the Gemara says, give me an example of a Beinoni. Moshe Rabbeinu and David HaMelech. Wow. They thought they were Beinonim. That's how Tzadikim think. Of course they're the greatest, but they never thought they're the biggest. They know they're not Rishonim. They know they don't know if they're the biggest Tzadikim because they're Anyanovim. They're, I'm a Beinoni. That's why he's the greatest. Moshe Rabbeinu and David HaMelech, Gemara says. Then, so you have 10 days. So in Rosh Hashanah, 3 books open. Tzadik Gomer, Rosh Gomer, and Beinoni. 10 days later, 2 books. Tzadik or Rosh. So the 10 days is for the Beinonim to do tshuva. The last day is Yom Kippur. Suppose you didn't do it on Yom Kippur. You have until Hoshana Rabbah. Yom Kippur is the 10th. Hoshana Rabbah is the 22nd. You have Hoshana Rabbah. Shoyim Gemurim get punished on Hoshana Rabbah. Therefore, the 10 Nazis were hung on Hoshana Rabbah in 1946. After the war. The Allies didn't know, but it came out of Shana Rabbah. Yom Hadin L'Rishoyim Gemurim. The 10 Nazis. One committed suicide the night before. Just like Haman's 11 children. One committed suicide, and the other 10 were hung. And when the last one was hung, Yemach Shmo Streicher, the editor of the paper, of the anti-Semitic paper, the Sturmer, he said, when they put the hood over his eye, over his face, 5 o'clock in the morning, in Nuremberg, in the school house, where they, in 1933, made the Nuremberg laws against the Jews. 12 years later, he said before they killed him, Purim Fest Fayuden. This is Purim for Jews. He didn't know it was Hoshana Rabbah, but he knew that Haman beat the Eden. We beat Haman. They wanted to wipe out all Jews. But it says in the Megillah, we killed 78,000 of them, not one Jew. So he said, they won, we lost. That's what he means. Purim Fest. Holiday of Purim for Yudin. Can you imagine? Hashem put it in his mouth. That was Hoshana Rabbah. 1946. Okay, let us finish. Conclusion. This is the conclusion. You know how important Talmud Torah is? Certain things in the Torah it says, L'man yurichon yumecha, your days will be lengthened. Means you did certain aveiros, you do certain mitzvahs, so your days is lengthened to what it was supposed to be before you were born. What kind of mitzvahs are that? Kibbut avoein, shluach hakan, b'marvad esedra every week, shnayim mikra v'chatagum, yirichun yamecha. You'll live the length that you were supposed to live. Yirichun yamecha. But there's another thing it says, Enishman, Levan Yirbu Yamechem, a more life, additional life, that only comes with Talmud Torah. Because look at the end of the parashah right here about tzitzis, right before tzitzis. Talmud Torah. Mind you, but you have a second life. Not just your regular life. You have a double life. A new life. More years than you were supposed to have. Year boon only comes to Talmud Torah. Either in your mouth, or in your arm, or in the doorpost. There's parshas of Shema in that doorpost. And parshas of Shema here. And in your mouth. If you dedicate your life for Talmud Torah, not just being a frum Jew. Talmud Torah. You can have another life. Yerubu, you can have a second life. Yerichon is 296. 296 is 15, the 2 is 17, 107 is 8. Long life. Tell them what you're supposed to live. But Yerubu is 218. You know how much that is? 2 and 1 is 3, 11. How much is 1 and 1? 2. You're going to get a second life. More years than you were supposed to get. The Talmud Torah is my Yerubu. Other things, Yerichon, you'll live the way you're supposed to live, but not longer. Talmud Torah is the most important. There's no mitzvah that's greater than Talmud Torah. Let's make a new beginning right now, all of us. We're Erev Rosh Chodesh Elul. This is your last chance, 12th month. Our last chance, everybody. To have a Shana Tovu Mesukah, sweet year. Not from God to us, but Hashem, from us to Hashem. Make it sweet. Not that he should do for me, I'll do for him. Then automatically it'll be a sweet year. How? Daven slower, daven deeper. Don't listen to talk lashon hara. Don't look at stuff you're not supposed to look at. Don't eat stuff that you have even a suffix. Every 3 minutes, learn Torah. You know, Torah, someone once said, a wise man, Torah, the page of Torah, Gemara, Chumash, that page, that paper bridge will get you to Olam Haba. Because you learn Torah. The paper bridge. That's how you get to Olam Haba. Through the paper. Gemara, Chumash, Shulchan Aruch, Shnai, whatever. That's the paper bridge that gets you to Olam Haba. You know why we're so different? We have to do tshuva. Bekodesh, because we are Kedoshim. We told you what Kedosh is. We're a very holy people. Very Kedoshim Tiyu, it says. You should become holy. Holier than you are. Not you are. You should always be holy and holier. Kedosh Tiyu, plural. The future. Because you're Am Kedosh. You're the holy nation. You know why you have to be Chazaq? Because you're Am HaNivchar, the chosen nation. You know why you have to be Chazaq? Because you're Am Nitzchi, your eternal nation. You know why you have to be Chazaq? Because you're Am Olam, you're eternal. No, we never got wiped off the earth. All of them are gone, all those 10 nations. Every one. 1,000-year Reich. Yeah, Hitler, yeah, 12 years. So let us hope the Yazor, God will help us, the Yogain and protect us, the Oshia and save us, the Cholachosnibo, anyone who trusts him. And then the Sigoleh, there shall be a vision. The Seiroen, all will see, everybody. Malchuso Aleinu, his kingdom over us, over all humanity. Bizman, Kariv, quickly. Venomar?
Amen.
Amen. Now, any questions you have?
Funny, you know, the place where you went for years and years ago, I got out of it with the Avodah Zarah, you know, up in the Catskills. The person who founded it died on Hashana Rabbah in the year 2009.
What was he?
It's a Buddhist place, you know, up in Woodstock.
Yeah.
The founder of it died in Hashana Rabbah.
Was he a Yid?
2009.
Was he a Yid?
Yeah, no, it's non-Jewish.
Nothing to do with that. Nothing to do with that. Only in...
Oh, no.
Yeah. The Nazis were going, right? 100% right. Yeah, that's
and
mean...
And he attracted a lot of Jewish people.
And there was a center of immorality in Woodstock. I remember that. And he died with his son, Shana Rabbah.
And also, the place up there, back in 1995, there was some friction with the Chabad up there, and they're continually blocking establishment of Chabad in Woodstock.
Yeah. Anybody else? Any questions about this subject? Rosh Hashanah, Elul, whatever. Okay. Have a wonderful evening. Thanks for inviting me.